We're rolling.
Yeah. Okay, so Bill, try that B flat major bebop there. Bebop scale. Sections of the scale, and make sure that this F sharp here is a passing tone as okay. much as you can.
All right,
you know what I mean.
Okay,
so try that one more time. One, two. Eight slips of paper, two separate piles. Put on the first four slips of paper, just put counts 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then the second pile, on the second four slips, put 1, 3, 5, 6. And somehow you have to indicate that it's chord tone 1, chord tone 3, chord tone 5, chord tone 6. You can kind of do Roman numerals. The other thing you can do sometimes sometimes what people do in music theory, in classical music theory, is they put the number with the caret on the top. Okay, that's another way that you can indicate that it's a chord tone and not a number of a beat. Okay, and then what I want you to do is draw two slips of paper from each of the piles, and then you'll have, then it'll tell you, I want you to start on the root of beat one, okay? Or I want you to start on the third on beat one.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of a random sort of way of getting, it's basically like playing a game, but it keeps you interested, in that kind of stuff. And then the other thing I would say that we haven't really talked about hardly at all is listen. Listen to every kind of tune you can that's rhythm changes, The internet is such a powerful tool that we can use these days. Just Google rhythm tunes that are rhythm changes, and it's going to come up with a whole list, Another great resource is Jamie Ebersold's website, jazzbooks.com. I'm sure you'll be able to find a whole list of rhythm changes tunes on that website. And once you've got the tunes, then look up, at first to kind of see what you like, look up, the players that you like playing that tune, and then go to iTunes and buy it, because we want to support the artists who record this music, who have done so much, to further this music, that's the main things that I would say about that. So just make sure that you apply all of these things for next week, and then we'll also apply them to anthropology. I wanted to spend all of today dealing with the foundation of rhythm changes, and then we can expound upon that by using what Charlie Parker, actually this is when you write a new melody when you might write a new melody over old chord changes, it's actually called a contrafact. Some of you may already know that. But next week we'll work on Charlie Parker's contrafact on rhythm changes. So I'll see you guys next week.
Cool. Yeah, man.